Alrighty. I can't hear myself. So, let's make sure my headphones are plugged in. Yes, they are. Okay, good. Alright. I think I was in the middle of one mission where I last left off. Let's see, so you can press jump. So I saw the Hammerite dude about things, and then he said, oh, that's right, I have to go to the, I have to go down to the docks, because the, this is where I have to go. So I'm in the old quarter heading down to the docks. Not there. Well, I guess there if I want to sell stuff, but I just came from Audale, so I just have to poot on down that way.
Was that a...
Shit, what's with all the guards?
Dead. The killer could still be around here.
Yeah, well, you... I mean, there should not be this many guards. Like, I knocked out...
All this hiding. So unnecessary.
What's my weapon situation like? Do I need to buy more arrows?
Come on out now.
All right.
I know someone's there. Oh, forget it. That murderer is long gone by now. Long gone.
Long gone for sure. Blood. Still in the good standing with the Hammerites? Yes. Okay. I didn't think guards came back down here. Ooh, that's probably where I need to go. Now I'm allied with the pagans, so... They shouldn't try to kill me for being in their duty hole. Runestay, I made them enchantings with my magicer wand, raising them undead again. I swear to God, reading pagan shit is awful. It's far worse than reading Hammerite stuff. So if I shoot an arrow at whatever cornerstone this dude's talking about, they can bury the guy there and be happy, but until then they're gonna keep raising the dead. So this would make both parties happy. So... I just have to find the cornerstone in the graveyard. pissed if I steal his money. Hey.
Yeah.
Hey, dude, I want your money. Let's double check our notes. Over there so I can steal your money.
Please, you stay away from them hammerheads.
Yeah, I like them hammerheads. Are there, Christ? So let's be these doozings. Notes and poot down here first before we do all this. No guard. I think that's a hammerite. Yes. Hey, Jauncey.
Guess I was wrong. Nothing's here.
A whole lot of nothing. Guards I previously knocked out are back to life. Some of them still even have dead bodies, and yet here they are. Jesus, mother frickin' Christ, how many goddamn guards are there? Just wanna go on a murdering spree. Get into the goddamn hemorrhoid compound. Jesus fucking Christ.
Miscreants. Oh, great master builder.
Okay. Keeper compound, it loops around there. Okay. Excuse me. Yes. So the, there's a note in the pagan things as I finally allied with the pagans, saying that they don't want this dude to, to be buried in the hemorrhoids. Because unless they grow a tree here, then it'd be okay. And until then, they're just gonna keep raising the dead. So if I grow a tree here, the dude can get buried here, and the frickin' dead'll stop raising. And I'll make the Hammerites happy that the dead aren't here, and I'll make the pagans happy that the, guy can get buried in the treesies. But I just gotta find the cornerstone that... Let's hope this reaches... Just the undead. Nothing to worry about. Well, I shouldn't have to worry about anything anyway. The Hammerites like me even better now that I killed that zombie. Fucking hate zombies though. Usually two zombies wandering around here, though, when they regen anyway. So I just need to find this... There it is. Pagan cornerstone. Alright. Let's do a save before... Thanks for the... on the toss. Yes, moss. I'm gonna sneeze. Man, my allergies have been going bananas today. Okay. Just in case this guy freaks the fuck out that I'm firing a goddamn pagan arrow in his Hammerite area. Alright, so that did work.
How art thou? Good evening.
And hopefully they'll be happy and the undead will stop rising. There we go, yes. Alright. Now I don't have to worry about being near Hammerites or pagans, and nobody will shank me. Oh, my back! Okay. Just save, and I need to get to the docks now, and I am over here. Hopefully there won't be 200 guards milling about. Fucking blackjack, though.
And the trickster with his venomous minions, hordes too numerous to name, but the worst...
Build or watch thee, Garrett.
Danke.
Hey! Found ya! Look now, die, you murderer! Somebody! I need help
with
him!
Son of a bitch. There. Why are there 200 freaking guards? It's like I knocked them all out, and then you complete one mission, and it resets freaking everything. Stab them all in their motherfucking eyes.
Thy will shall be done, Master Builder, in the great things. It is not enough to read the precepts. Any fool can't open a book. It is the work of a lifetime to carry out the precepts.
I just hear something?
Heard nothing. Are there, Christ. I like how my footsteps are somehow different than everybody else's, and they can all see, like, distinguish my footprints from somebody else's.
Evening.
Well, well, and thou?
Docks. Yes. So much light. So, I just came out of the old quarter. I'm down by the docks, but I'm not sure where by the docks I need to be. Shellbridge Cradle to see what you can learn about the hag. The cradle is in the old quarter near the gate to the docks. Okay, so I didn't need to go to the docks, but it's just near the docks. So, oh, that's right. Derp. There it is. I remember being like, that's where I need to go, and then completely forgetting about that.
The Shalebridge Cradle. It used to be an insane asylum, and before that, it was an orphanage. One night a fire started, no one knows how, and after that, they left the place abandoned. If there's a way to cram more misery into one building's history, I can't think of it. I'm here to learn about the old woman who attacked me in the Keeper compound. Drept said he saw the hag here at the orphanage long ago, when his childhood friend was murdered. He's never dared to come back, but I don't think I have much choice. It's a thin lead, but it's all I have left. I've never robbed an orphanage before, and I can't say I'm looking forward to this visit. There's no telling what I'll find inside. I'm used to the dark, but this feels like a house with bad dreams.
Always a good sign. Hopefully I have enough equipment for what I'm looking for. Left or right? Well, it looks like I can see some water arrows to the left. So we're gonna head that way first. Nothing like flies to signal dead people. God, I hope there aren't zombies in here. I don't really like the way this is shaping up. Trees. That's probably the way in right there. I'll be able to flood or drain the canal from here. I think I'm going to explore this level first. If anything, I expect the undead to be in here. Nothing like hearing, like, the undead screams to make you feel warm and comfortable in a place. It was better before. There are too many rules to remember. Don't go here. Don't touch that. Don't talk to the patients. Doctors are just as scary as the patients. Miss Arthur says orphans shouldn't complain. Well, orphans shouldn't complain if you're getting a bed and a room and all that. I don't like the screams of ghosts. But I got a bad feeling. It's quiet. Too quiet. I just got a feeling I'm gonna come up against a foe that I have not, like, been up against yet, and it's gonna be awful. Up or down? Pick your poison. I think we'll go down. Splash, we were taking a bath all upon a Saturday night. going this way because I saw what I thought was a letter on something down here from above, so we're hoping to find that letter. Here it is. Case number 7C, Pins, patient history. Entry 1. Admitted to hospital for observation and treatment by her family. Completely unresponsive to questions or the presence of others. Due to her sensitive age, recommended she be placed under Dr. Sandbridge's expert care, Dr. Hanscom. Entry 2. Told the family today that the subject will never be well enough to return home. As proof, I showed them her cell, which of course is grotesquely outfitted in the same way as the murder scene. I believe on some level they were relieved. D.S. Entry 3. The board has decided to allow her continued visits to the balcony with her quote-unquote birdhouse. Okay, so this is a insane asylum note as opposed to an orphanage note left above. Is this a boiler?
It's burned out. They must have kept a spare fuse somewhere.
I wonder what it is. Well, if this is burnout, I probably don't need it. I can just find another one. Some shinies. Case number 6F, Topper. Patient history. Entry 1. Brought in by City Watch, hysterical. Carries an urn that contains the assage of what authorities think might be her own infant. Refers to self as Mama Topper. Could prove a difficult case to cure. Dr. Sandridge. Entry 2. Efforts to take the infant ashes away are always met with the same self-destructive behavior. Now we see no harm in allowing the subject to carry them with her during a weekly walk in the exercise yard. Inform Dr. Hashcom, I approve the use of his experimental heat therapy. So, are we burning people alive? Is that how the place caught on fire? Always good. Always good sounds, let me tell you that. Always good. Oh, man, I don't like this. I should probably do a real save at some point. Okay. Oh, it's a doorway. Oh, no, wait, that's where I came in. This is what I wanted to look at. Alright, can't light that. Got some vials of shit. You know, no one's here now, but I got a really bad feeling that, like, this place is gonna be filled with people soon enough. But at least everything's freaking dark, so I can hide well. Although, I don't know if I should be excited about that or not. Return to the cathedral? Is that the one where all the murder-freaking zombies were and all the ghosts and crap? More vials of stuff and a cage I'm avoiding. Alright, let's do a little savey-save before we go poking at this cage. Yeah, I knew we'd be able to open it. There's nothing in there. Do I want to open this? Is this going to unleash hell? If I go in there, is it going to close on me? I don't see if anything of interest in here. I don't want to go in there. Alright, well. Jesus Christ, I just scared myself by stepping on that. Alright, well. Nothing downstairs at the moment. Let's go back upstairs. Alright. Alright. Now I can either go upstairs here or up the stairs in the foyer. Let's start here since we're here already. Emergency lockdown porticles can only be opened when the power is restored. So I need to find that other fuse. Oh, because that's not creepy. Not at all. Let's just... I don't know if you can see that on your screen, but there is a face-shaped amulet right there. Right there, you see that? You see it? God, that's creepy as all shit. Let's just have a quick save.
That didn't work. Maybe there's a fuse box in the basement.
Yeah, I already removed the fuse. Go through this. Let's save that door for later and start here. Okay, okay. What's this say? Lobby. Shinies. I don't like this place. Even if it is wall decor, Jauncey, it's still scary as hell crap. You know, guys, I'm Garrett. I'm not here to hurt you. If anything, I will help you. So please, let me help you. Help me help you. Okay. Where's this go? Nowhere. Someone's knocking and or walking. I really don't like this. I wonder if there's a backup fuse downstairs that I just never found. Well, this is the front entrance, okay. Nobody's home. I'm gonna sleep well tonight, tell you that much, Christ. Anything? Nothing. Alright, so... Before I go upstairs of the lobby, let's check out the other side. Okay. I didn't see a replacement fuse downstairs. Maybe they keep one upstairs. And I creep. Yeah. Creeping on the down. Derp, 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 herp, derp. Oh, you know what? As soon as I restore power, all these frickin' lights are gonna come on, I'll tell you that much. That's gonna suck. I hear a fire burning when there is none. Bet you that'll be lit up later. Thank you. Always good when they give you fucking health potions. I'm guessing oil to light on fire. Before I go this way, should I really? I'm gonna quick save and then we're gonna open that door and then see if I'm going to regret opening this door. I don't like this level at all. Heat therapy to ameliorate dampness in hyper-emotive patients by Dr. William Hanscom. Patients who have lost touch with reality often have marked dampness to their extremities, a clamminess of the hand, a sweatiness of the foot. Symptoms result from an excess of emotive humors that are trapped within the individual due to bile deficiency. Although electrical regimes are often used with this type of patient, I have also had great success with the application of heat. The heat must be of the dry variety, as hot water submersion only exacerbates the symptoms by increasing emotive humors. The hot elements must be laid directly on the skin to draw away the excess of moisture. So he's literally burning people alive. Okay, great. We're off to a good start. Now, hopefully these people will understand that I am not the one burning them alive. And we'll be like, hey Garrett, thanks. Thanks a bunch for liberating me. Go upstairs, or this way. I think we're gonna go this way. Now this is where the banging's coming from, huh? That. Great, more health potions. Alright, I think this leads to the stairs that were in the foyer. Down that way. Maybe not? Oh, this is the other side of stairs, okay. Health potions. Going well, let me tell you this. They've given me three health potions so far. Why would they give you that many health potions if you don't need them? Okay. Stew. I got the whole thing worked out. First, ain't no need for you to worry. I found a real good hiding place for the bag of gold teeth. It's real hard to find, and anyway, it's in the morgue. Ain't nobody goes there unless they have to, or they did. Know what I mean? I figure a couple more days, a week tops, and I'll have yanked enough gold teeth from these poor dead loonies to buy something real fancy. You just have to do your part, which is find us a buyer. The kind that don't ask too many questions. I mean, you can't just walk into any old place and sell a bag of gold teeth. Don't let me down. Desmond. Alright, well, that gives me something to look for in the morgue. Not like I really want to go to the morgue. Now I wonder... I cannot climb this, but I have a feeling I'll be hiding here at some point. More locked doors. I'm guessing this was the bed area for the insane asylum slash orphanage when it was an orphanage. Deep breaths, deep breaths. I'll have to go through some of these boarded up doors at some point. Alright. That's gonna be a light. And none of these lights I'll be able to put out either. Not looking forward to when all these lights turn back on. Sounds like a wooden apple, Christ. That's gonna be fun to walk across later, I'll tell you that. There's the stairs. So who's banging on the other side of these doors? Is this like the undead? No shit, Sherlock. I hear a strange knocking sound from the attic. I don't like it. There's that painting we heard about earlier.
She looks familiar. It's that keeper translator girl. But that can't be. This portrait must be as old as the building.
I can hear you breathing. Nobody here in the cradle does that anymore. How did you get in? My name is Laurel. Something changed when you saw my picture. That's why you can hear me now. I want to leave here, but I can't. The cradle won't let any of us go. Will you help me?
Yes.
They filled up a bottle with my blood. It's down in the storm cellar. It's very dark down there. Please find the bottle and drop it into a drain pipe so it will end up outside. It's important.
I'll help you out, my little friend. But I got a feeling there's gonna be people trying to stop me. Can I touch you? No. Okay. That was... things went better than expected. Like, I didn't get killed or shanked or... freak out. All the way back downstairs again, but at least I got a new... thingy. That's gonna light up the entire fucking place, tell you that much. I bet you have to come all the way back upstairs for a motherfucking key to the storm cellar, I can tell you that. Storm cellar is, but I'm guessing it's behind a door that I don't have access to at the moment. Everybody can see me. Hopefully no one else is down here.
This one must be hers. It's still warm. Yeah. Great.
Well, I'm glad I decided to look in here. Where am I gonna find a motherfucking storm drain? Just like drop this in the drain and GTFO. Where would there be a drain? I don't recall having seen one. Dark. There's a light in there now.
That's against the cage where they used to put the new patients until a cell opened up. You should stay out of there, or the cradle might see you and try to keep you here forever.
I will take your suggestion and not enter it. I decided to crawl on the wrong side of the ladder. Alright, well, there isn't a drain down there. Level either. Can't I just take it outside with me? Not allowed. See if she's saying anything.
It won't open. That's not a good sign.
This is a staircase I didn't go up before. Okay, I know where he is. Told you that fire would be lit up. Oh, is this a storm drain?
That's good. The bottle is outside now, where the cradle can't see it. I have to get rid of all my things. Cradle uses them to remember me. That's how it keeps me here. There's a ward here called Whitehall, where they kept the very bad patients. One of them took my nightgown back to his cell. It's still there. Please get my nightgown, and then burn it up in the morgue.
Bitch, I promised you I'd get you your blood. But this is turning into, like, the world's worst scavenger hunt. Why do I gotta burn it up in the morgue? Is this furnace not enough for you? Alright. Assuming this is the white place. Storm cellar is down there. Storm cellar. Staff tower. Staff tower, and I don't want to go wherever that mystery void is. Exercise yard.
The staff tower. Nobody is allowed up there.
Nobody, eh? Nobody but the staff. Looks like they got some good shiny shinies. Shiny shiny. I'm not a big candy person. Like, I like candy, but it's very much an impulse item for me. Alright, you know what? We're not supposed to go to the exercise yard, so there's probably nothing deadly out there just yet. I don't know where this Whitehall is that I'm supposed to go, where all the very, very bad people are, but we'll do a quick save and head out to the exercise yard. If it'll let me. Sure. Maybe I have to get to this place via the inner cradle. Man. This isn't an exercise yard. This is hell. Why is this glowing eerily? Okay. Your clock. This is where Bird Lady. Down, Garrett, down. Going down, 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 down. What's that? The fuck was that? To go downstairs now. Did you see that, John C? Did you see that thing walking around with, like, the fucking electrodes on its head? Like, how do you kill that? Can you kill that? Will flash bombs work on it? Will mines work on it? Will arrows work on it? I went that way. Arrows aren't going to work, you're saying. What about holy water and fire? They gave me a lot of oil that I can light on fire. I've got 5 holy waters. spirit. God, I hear his little buzzing. Dr. Sandbridge, I suppose you have to thank you for the bottle of wine that was delivered to my office. Gravecourt Red, not an easy vintage to come by or afford. If you think this sweetens our little arrangement we have, then you're right, it does. Perhaps we should drink this fine wine together and discuss the particulars, or perhaps it is too valuable to drink. Perhaps we should wait for a more special occasion. Till then, it shall remain in my office. You're buzzing. Observatory. See, I can hear the buzzing. Oh, lights are flickering over there. Guess we can see if holy water works. Am I gonna be able to see them? Oh shit. I'm stuck. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god, I'm gonna die. Let's reload and try that again. Cause I'm not sure if the first holy water worked or not. Shortcut code so I isn't the item that throws, because I have to take my hand off the mouse to do that, and I don't like that. He didn't dust, though. Does that mean he can get back up? What does that say? Ouch. Can you get back up? Ah, Whitehall. Thank you. this mean that I'm going to see 9 different ghosts walking around here? Good thing I didn't bother to stock up on flash bombs before I came in here. Fine, as long as I know how to kill them now. This is an awfully long drop. At least nothing's on the goddamn elevator. Christ. Do I want to go up to the seclusion chamber? I'm not confident I do. Joker up here, Christ. That kind of looks like a zombie arm that's gonna come to life. I don't feel too... What is that? That's a boffer item. Doesn't look like a body or anything. Looks like someone strung up pillows. It's glowing, so I guess it's like reminiscent of a ghost that's walking around here. Like items that you have to take to get rid of the ghosts. Got 4 fire arrows. I don't think I want to waste it on that to see if it'll burn. So, how does one get down from the isolation chamber? The hard way, I guess, huh? That's not what I wanted to do. I wanted to climb the wall, but... So let's reload, because I don't want to waste any of those health potions that they gave me. I mean, I guess I could just sneak around these dudes instead of, like, killing them, but... I'd rather not have a panic attack while I'm playing a game. It's much easier to just kill everybody. Since I don't need to go up there, since there is literally nothing up there for me. Cannot climb the walls. F, there we go. Shit. Heavy breathing, Christ. We should go. Well, they're both gonna hit the door, then I'm not gonna waste my time with it, Christ. Better. Get in there to get to that. Excuse me. Can I move you? No. Okay, awesome. I really wish the lights would stop flickering if they died. I hope I'm not giving anybody this injury. The tinkerer. Breathing just sounds really creepily like a pervert. I mean, I don't want to know what this dude was doing with this little girl's nightgown, I'll tell you that much.
Those bricks look a little uneven. Someone did some amateur work.
To be known. Oh, and here's the guy who did the telescoping. Oh.
The staff blamed him for what happened to me. They were wrong.
That's just the dude with the music box or whatever. I keep seeing it flash and I keep thinking it's a shiny I can take, but it's not. Don't ask me why I keep creeping even though there's like... there hasn't been a ghost. Why is that glitching? Maybe it sounds like somebody's crying. Scared crying is kind of what it sounds like. Man, can you imagine that? If someone was just like, you need to be scared, like you were fucking beaten or something, and cry. There's this dude's music box. I guess the other one was a Tinder box. Okay, that scared me. I did not think that that was from this dude. Bird lady. a shit ton of skulls. So, alright, Bird Lady's creepy. Now I'm down to 2 flash vines. Back at the beginning. I'm going back where I started. Yes, I am. I just did a big circle. Great. Let's do a quick save. Oh, I guess we should do a real save. Fat man that they were talking about with the glow up. Now. Except for this one. Oh my god, that was the scariest thing. Isn't it dying? Die! 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 They all kind of look like Pinhead. Alright, well, no more flash mines, no more fire arrows. All I've got left are mines. Great. You know what? I don't know where I saved last, but I think we're going to have to just try that whole thing over again. Okay. Holy shit, it came back alive, it came back alive! Oh, I didn't expect that. Die for really reals. Why won't you really, really die? I hate you. Oh my god, I hate you. Baby, walk next to that mine. Sorry, Jauncey, I'll see you later. I'm probably gonna call it quits after this. I wanted to try and finish this out, but I don't think I'm gonna be able to finish it all out tonight.
All wrapped up in wet bandages. He heard me come in and started making screaming noises. I think he wanted me to help him, but I was too afraid.
Where the fuck did it go? A motherfucking bitch. Alright, I'll tell you what, I think I'm just gonna call it quits tonight. Dealing with these things is annoying. I thought for sure it would blow up next to him, but apparently not. This is as good a place as any to stop, so.